Hey, you are most welcome here. So today I'm going to take you the easiest way of actually applying for a TIN number, a personal TIN or a business TIN. My name is Ronnie Hatwaira and I'm glad that you chose this particular channel for this type of content. And if you're enjoying the video, please leave a like, and maybe if you could also subscribe. And I'm also known as Afroboy Tech, so let's get started. So to get started, there's an old way of actually getting through this. That's basically uploading a file. That's an Excel file that is macro enabled. Then you just get to fill everything, and then you validate the file. And then after validating the file, you upload the file to the URA portal. But this is gonna be easy and instant. So just type in your browser, ura.go.ug. So after going to ura.go.ug, you go under e-services. So when you click on e-services, it automatically loads another page for e-services, things that you can do for yourself. There's what we call instant TIN registration. So you just click on it. So after clicking on it, we have two applicant categories, such as individual, that is basically a personal TIN, and then non-individual, basically a business name or a business company or a company or whatever it is. So basically, this part is for businesses, companies. This part is for individuals or personal. So I already have a NIN, but I'm going to simulate one process. So if you come here, you just type in your ID. For example, maybe my ID name, my ID could be CM9600. Then after typing in your ID, to automatically load your information here. And then you just have to load your names. Actually, you have to put in your date, your birth of date. You put in your title, marital status. Fill this short form. If you're employed, you tick where you fall. If you're unemployed, you can leave this blank. Then address and contact details. I would have advised you that you use the address and contact details that actually used when you're applying for your national ID, the information on your national ID, so that this process goes so smoothly. So just click you're not a robot, and then you submit application, and that's it. So you'll if you put everything correct, they will inform you, and you can actually even track your TIN application process and all those things. So under here, there's some there's an email. You have to put in your email address for any other further information, such that you're actually reached out to in case of anything. So if you're not a comp if you're not an individual and you want to apply for a company, you click on non-individual. I've already filled this up, so I already put in my business registration number. And when you put in this, it automatically autofills the rest of the information here. So you just have to come and scroll through and maybe select where you belong or where your company belongs, the business classification. Maybe you're a business, maybe you do construction. You click on construction. After click on construction, you click on the subdivision, then subdivision, the class. So yeah, the business address, where the business is located, then persons related to the entity. This could be the directors, so you can add a person if there's one more director, or there are more than one directors. And these directors, it is mandatory, not actually mandatory, but it is advisable to have to also these directors be having or owning TIN numbers. So basically, if he has TIN, just check this list, this here, and then it automatically brings something else to add the TIN number. So yes, this is where now you add the TIN, then they enter the birth of date for the director, then authorized contact person. This could be someone that who could reach out to in case of anything. You can now you can add, if it made, if you don't have it, is okay. Then attachment, you can add files, certificate of registration or form 7 or form 20. And then you choose the file. You can choose the file here. After choosing, it automatically uploads. Then you click on this confirmation button, then you sign off. After clicking on this, it automatically brings the submit button, and then you submit for your business. That's it for this video. The longer process of getting the URA is actually I don't see it here, but basically that was it for this video, and have a blessed one. Please subscribe if you enjoy the video.